you, Cyrus.
Where do you think?
Where are you? Gotcha!
Ouch!
How do you like that?
Thank you. were going to steal something, weren't you? Tell the truth.
No, I just wanted to look at the flowers.
Is there a problem here?
Your Highness, this little brat here snuck into the garden. I am sure he was planning on stealing something from the castle.
No, I already told you. I just wanted to look at the flowers. Let me go!
Release him.
Huh?
Just do it.
Yes, Your Highness.
So, you like flowers, do you?
Yeah, I do. Looking at them somehow makes me feel good.
Oh, then I guess you're not a thief. I'm sorry. Forgive me.
Oh, you believe me?
What? You're lying?
Oh, it's really true.
Very well. I believe you. So, where did you come from?
I don't have a home. I'm all alone.
I see. All right. From now on, I'm putting you in charge of this flower bed.
What?
Your Highness!
No way. Really? Well, why me?
I thought you liked flowers.
Yes, but...
Do you mean to disobey the Queen's orders?
Okay, I'll do it. Like a caretaker, right? I guess that wouldn't be too bad.
So, what's your name?
Name? My name?
It's okay. That's fine. Your name here at the castle will be Cyrus. What do you think?
Cyrus?
Yes, I think it suits you well. I want you to give all these flowers here plenty of love and attention.
Listen well. If you wish to see my master, you must first speak his true name. That is correct. You may pass.
Griffin!
It's all over for you! I hope you're ready!
think you can conquer me, do you? I commend you on being able to bring this palace down. But you underestimate me, and I find that most disturbing. In fact, I believe a demonstration of my true power is in order. Now you shall pay for your transgressions and disappear from the face of the world!
Alexander, we have to run. Our enemies are almost here.
No. You go alone, Cyrus. I'll stay behind.
No, I won't do that. You'll be killed.
Please, Cyrus, just do as I say. I am queen of this land. Whatever may happen, I must live as this country lives and die as this country dies. That is my role. Now go, Cyrus, please.
No. No! Alexandra!
Alexandra, I'm all alone now. The humans started attacking and killing each other just for a few shiny stones. But when they gathered all the stones together, Alexandra, you knew this would happen, didn't you? Those humans, it would be better if they never existed. Only it had been just you and me from the beginning. Those humans. Oh. shouldn't I destroy the humans? Alexandra. Alexandra. What they did to you. They make war. They kill each other. They involve people who have nothing to do with them, just to get the power of the stones. They don't deserve to live. It's natural that they be wiped out. I'm not the bad one. It's not me. They're to blame. I just wanted to be with you a little longer. That's all. That's all I wanted.
It's true that humans have strong desires. And they often make mistakes when they try to fulfill those desires. But humans also possess something very important. I think that even you know what that is, Cyrus. You've been watching this whole time, haven't you? You've seen the boy on his journey. You realized a long time ago that you are wrong this time. The precious thing they have inside them, it's something that must not be destroyed. Something that must be passed on. Remember back, Cyrus. Remember that you have an important role in life. You must remember.
Alexandra, I don't understand. I just don't understand.
Oblivion?
The moon! It's falling!
What? Still alive, are you?
your side now.
You? Max, don't worry about me. Just go after him.
Cake! 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 Get off your lazy behind! Piece of cake! to me. Piece of cake.
That was inside me. Then again, it was probably me who created it in the first place. At last, it's all over. Alexandra, I remember. I've remembered what I have to do. I know what was passed on to me in my memory. How to stop the Star of Oblivion. The one who disarms it. The ancient ones told my ancestors how to stop the Star of Oblivion, but that memory was locked away. My family has passed down that knowledge from generation to generation. One day, when humans became worthy, the Star of Oblivion was to be stopped. That is my role and my purpose. At last, that time has come. Now there is no need for the blue moon. Moon! You have fulfilled your purpose. Return to the dust that bore you.
Thank you.
Cassandra. This is what you meant, isn't it?
Congratulations, Cyrus. You were magnificent.
Thank you. You opened my eyes. I think I've always been waiting for this moment. Time to say farewell. Goodbye, my friends.
So, beneath it all, Cyrus was just a nice little boy with a huge responsibility. So big, he almost couldn't handle it. But now he's finally going to a place he can call home.
Yeah. Thanks to Cyrus, the world can go on without being destroyed ever again. The ruler of darkness, Emperor Griffin. There never really was such a person. He was just a mass illusion created by the evil in men's hearts.
Wow, that's pretty deep, Max. Kind of poetic, really.
Well, you know.
We've sure been through a lot, but I guess it's over. There's only one moon in the sky now.
Yeah, and so it begins. A new era bathed in the light of a single moon.
Ugh, that's laying it on a bit thick. But will people ever believe there was once two moons?
They might. People can lock their special memories in their hearts. But at some point, they just forget to take them out again. This incredible adventure that we all shared, one day, it may too end up being forgotten. The people in the future will likely forget many things. The fact that I was here, and also that long ago, two moons shined down from the starry sky.
It's time for us to say goodbye too, hey Max? It was fun traveling with you. I won't ever forget you. And Max, you'd better not forget me either.
Don't worry. I won't forget you, Monica. Or my journey, or how we fought together. I could never forget any of that.
Well, good then.
I consider it a true honor to have met you, Max.
That goes for me as well.
Max, you were wonderful. I'm so proud of you.
Mother!
It's time to say goodbye, Max. Be strong, my son.
I will. And I'm not going to cry. I've seen lots of tears shed lately, and it's made me a stronger person.
Max, there was so much I wanted to tell you. And there was so much I wanted to hear about you. I'm so sorry.
I know. I'll write you a letter, Mother. I'll put in it everything that happened on our adventure. Then I'll hide the letter right here, so that it'll reach you even in the future. Mother?
Yes. I look forward to that.
Mother, I'm so happy that I was able to meet you.
Always be good to yourself, Max. Goodbye, my heart.
Mother!
Closing. This journey was like some kind of dream. Castles floating in the air, moons becoming one.
Yeah, just like a dream.
You're right. Your journey was just a dream. There's always been just one moon. All this may just have been a long, long dream shown to us humans by the ancients to warn us.
A dream, huh? Yeah, right.
Well, Mother, it turned out a little long, but this is finally the end of my letter. We really had an amazing adventure. But it was a lot of fun, too. After all, I managed to meet you and Monica. Finally, this is our true goodbye. Please, Mother, don't forget about me. Take care. I'll be here in my time. Doing fine. Farewell to my future mother.
Take my chances, racing time, rewriting the book for all to see. On my own, I can ride the winds of change to heal a broken time, a broken world. Pierce the sky.